we know that a muscle is made up of fasciculi, and each fasciculus contains many muscle fibers. Now, muscle fibers are innervated by motor neurons coming out of the spinal cord. Each motor neuron supplies more than one muscle fiber. This group of fibers innervated by the same motor neuron, including the neuron itself, is called a motor unit. The number of fibers in a motor unit depends on the type of muscle. In general, small muscles that need quick and precise control have fewer muscle fibers per motor unit. For example, some laryngeal muscles have only 2 or 3 muscle fibers per motor unit. On the other hand, large muscles that don't require fine control, like the soleus muscle, have hundreds of muscle fibers per unit. On average, there are about 80 to 100 muscle fibers per motor unit in the body. An important thing to note is that the muscle fibers within a motor unit are not all clumped together like this. Instead, they overlap with other motor units in groups of 3 to 15 fibers. This overlapping arrangement allows the motor units to work together in supporting each other's contractions rather than contracting entirely as individual segments. So this was all about the motor unit. In summary, a motor unit is a group of all the muscle fibers supplied by the same neuron. The number of fibers in a motor unit depends on how much precision is needed in the movement of that muscle. And fibers from neighboring motor units overlap with each other to support each other's contraction. That's it for this video. Click here to read the notes on this video at our website. You can also explore our entire physiology animation video library over there. To support my free content creation, first leave a nice comment and then share the video with all your friends and colleagues. Thanks for watching. See you in the next.